foam everywhere, filling the air. Oh, how they pound, rising their sound, boiling and down, telling their tale. Merry, 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 wild people sing songs of the cheer. Christmas is here. Merry, 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 ding dong. Merry, 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 ding dong. All of this ding dong.
It's the story of the misfit who saves the day, beloved and remembered by all, and going down in history, all because of his special gift and how he uses it. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer features Susan Allen and our young adults, Madden Gravett, Kelsey Meekins, and Burley McAvoy. You know Dasher and Dancer and Prancer and Vixen. You know Comet and Cupid and Donner and Blitzen. But do you recall the most famous reindeer of all?
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer had a very shiny nose. And if you ever saw it, you would even say it glowed
like a light bulb.
All of the other reindeer used to laugh and call him names. They never let poor Rudolph join in any reindeer game.
Like Monopoly.
Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say,
in his underwear,
Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight? Then all the reindeer
loved him,
as they shouted out with glee, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
And it really is just all about the fun and having a good time at Christmas time. Ready?
bells swing and jingle bells ring, snowing and blowing up bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun. Jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bells chime in jingle bell time. Dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square. In the frosty air, what a bright time, it's the right time to rock the night away. Jingle bell time, it's a swell time to go gliding in a one-horse sleigh. Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock. Mix and mingle in a jingling beat. That's the jingle bell rock.
Jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bells chime in jingle bell time. Dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square. In the frosty air.
What a bright time. It's the right time to rock the night away. Jingle bell time, it's a swell time to go gliding in a one-horse sleigh. Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock. Mix and mingle in a jingling beat. That's the jingle bell. That's the jingle bell. That's the jingle bell rock.
Well, I had a lot of fun researching all these songs and getting a little bit of the backstories. This next one, I want to tell you about this. In 1953, one of the hottest songs on the radio featured a 10-year-old girl named Kayla Peavy pleading with Santa Claus for a hippopotamus for Christmas. But here's where it gets cool, because the story actually illustrates one of the tenets of our teachings, right? That when we ask the universe for something, ask, believe, and get ready to receive, you actually can get what you want. So, Gala's hometown zoo didn't actually have a hippopotamus. When the song came out, she teamed up with the local newspaper to encourage people to send in enough money so that they could actually buy one for the zoo. After the song debuted on the Ed Sullivan Show. Anybody in here remember Ed Sullivan Show? $3,000 later, Matilda, the hippopotamus, arrived on Christmas Eve, a fitting gift for someone who would so enthusiastically declare, "No crocodiles, no rhinoceroses, I only like hippopotamuses, and hippopotamuses like me too." That was her big hit, her one big hit. So now she's retired, been married for 53 years. She says she still sings regularly in church, but not the hippo song. She says laughing because it's not really a church song. So that's why we do it here.
I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. Only a hippopotamus will do. Don't want a doll, no dinky tinker toy. I want a hippopotamus to play with and enjoy. I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. I don't think Santa Claus will mind to you. He won't have to use our dirty chimney flue. Just bring him through the front door, that's the easy thing to do. Only a hippopotamus will do. No crocodiles, no rhinoceroses. I only like hippopotamuses, and hippopotamuses like me too. up but then. The teacher says a hippo is a vegetarian. There's lots of room for him in our two-car garage. I feed him there and wash him there and give him his massage.
Soundtrack.
Yes.
And it will feature our two young lady soloists. Both of you, or just the one?
Just the one.
Well, I should have introduced Kelsey before. Sorry about that. That was Kelsey singing the last time, along with Maddie. And Maddie is our soloist for this number. Let's give my big round. Welcome.
Oh.
So I'd like to invite all the children to come up. We've got a nice little space here for all of you. One of the oldest and most popular Christmas poems was first published on December 23rd in 1823. It was published in the Choice Sentinel newspaper in upstate New York, and it was originally called A Visit from St. Nicholas. Anyone know the other name? "'Twas the Night Before Christmas."
Yes.
So there's a little question about who the author was, but there's no question about who's reading it today. We've got Susan Allen, and we've got Brody McAvoy. And we want to give a little extra love to Mr. Brody there with an amazing baritone voice. If you have
"'Twas the night before Christmas, when all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads.
And Mama and her chief and I and my cat had just settled our brains for long winter's nap. When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters, threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new fallen snow gave a luster of midday the objects below. And what to my wandering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh with 8 tiny reindeer, and a little driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick.
More rapid than eagles his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen. On, Comet, on, Cupid, on, Donder and Blitzen, to the top of the porch, to the top of the wall. Now dash away, dash away, dash away, all. As dry leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky. So up to the housetop the coursers they flew, with a sleigh full of toys, and St. Nicholas, too. And then in a twinkling I heard on the roof, the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound.
He was all dressed in fur from head to his foot, and all his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back. He looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry, his cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard on his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke, it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him, in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread.
He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work, and he filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk, and laying his finger aside of his nose, and giving a nod, up the chimney he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim ere he drove out of sight, "Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night." Yeah.
She was trying so hard to get this voice to play along, and they just not having it. They were not having that. All right. The next song features our. What's going on?
I'm having a costume moment.
Oh, okay.
Okay, we're good.
Is our featured soloist ready? There she is. Our choir director. Not our choir director, sorry. She's our music department director. Sorry, she's jack of all trades. She does a little of everything. Practitioner in training, and she's going to sing arms. Yes.
And this is how I feel about spirit and finding this wonderful place.
It's more than
Choir's next song features the other part of that dynamic duo of Donna and Norma, with Norma singing Emmanuel. Norma is the treasurer of our board and also jack of all trades. A lot of the things that get done in this place happen with those two ladies. And a practitioner in training. I missed that. Our other practitioner in training.
Thank you.
people mistakenly assume this next Christmas classic has been around for years and that it's of European origin. But it was actually written in 1962 during the Cuban Missile Crisis as a powerful plea for peace by a man who had experienced the horrors of war. The song's message of peace is as relevant today as it was then. The songwriter was a Frenchman named Noël Reynier, who was forced to serve in the German army during the German occupation of France during World War II. After the war, he moved to the US and built a safe, secure life for himself. He knew the fear and terror of being close to death, and people in this country at that time were afraid that we were heading into another war. Noël was a songwriter and a record producer asked him to write a holiday song. "I had thought I'd never write a Christmas song," he recalled. "Christmas had become so commercial, but this was the time of the Cuban Missile Crisis. In the studio, the producer was actually listening to the radio to see if we were going to be obliterated. En route to my home that day, I saw two mothers with their babies in strollers. The little angels were looking at each other and smiling. All of a sudden, my mood was extraordinary. A glimpse of those babies filled his heart with poetry. And so it starts. The little ones reminded him of newborn lambs, and thus the song begins, said the night wind to the little lamb. Do you hear what I hear?
Teachings and our beliefs here. the night of the deep.